Another Divi tutorial, and today we will talk about the email open module on Divi. So I'm gonna help you how you can avoid those mistakes. Like normally when you fetch your service news service provider on your module in Divi, you can experience or you might experience some problems, especially in fetching connection, because the steps that you did is not right. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you the step-by-step process in order process to avoid those mistakes. So we will use MailChimp as an example for the service provider, but I mean all the service providers that listed on the email module in Divi, like HubSpot, ConvertKit, Constant Contact, or whatever service provider it is, the process is just that, it's just the same. So just follow the in order process that I'm gonna show with you today in order to avoid the fetching issue. And we will also cover how you can create a custom fields onto your email open form. Everything is really the best practices of email open form module and Divi. So without further ado, let's dive in to the tutorial. 1, 2, 3. So I'm gonna use MailChimp as our service provider. So, but the process on other service provider is still the same. So the first thing that you need to do is you create a list first. So in order to create a list in MailChimp, go to the audience and then audience dashboard, and you scroll down to see all your audience. So click the view audiences. Now we will create a list, and I will call that WordPress, or just call that WordPress, and then I'm gonna use my email address for the meantime. So reason is you need to verify your email address in order to make your list working well. So if you don't have, because this press is a different domain, so if you don't have access on that, you need to talk to your to the owner that we need to verify your email address. So let's put the information, then you need to put your details. So people who are interested in press. For the form settings, I would not really recommend this one for a weekly newsletter or a general subscription, because they need to confirm the subscription first. They will do a two process. They will submit the form, and then they will also confirm that on your other email address, which is kind of bummer. So, but if you want that kind of security, then you can enable it. But for me, I will just keep that disabled. And for the GDPR, I'll just keep that disabled as well, because we're not from the UK. And this one, I'm gonna keep that disabled too, and saved. Now, once you created a list, you need to go to your sign up forms, and you need to finalize your fields. So by default, sign up form has a email address, a first name and last name, address and a phone number. So what if you want to add additional fields? So you need to configure first your MailChimp account before going to the Divi website, because sometimes you might experience some fetching if you did not configure your MailChimp first and you dive in directly to the website. So let's set up a additional fields for now. So I'm gonna drag that there, and then I'll add an information like describe yourself, and are you a journalist, a blogger, or a business owner, or investor. So we have that drop down, our options. Okay, now I'm already good with that. Like, I just want to know who they are. And then once you're ready, final with your fields, we can then go to our website. Okay, and then I'm gonna enable the visual builder, and
add an email open module. So click that one and look for an email open. So for the email open, I'll just keep this one contact us. And I'll just keep the description. I'm going to remove the description. And then for the fields, I want this to be not full width. So as you can see in here, like the default is the first name, last name, and email address. So we need to configure that that thing in here, because you will experience a problem if you did not configure your service provider first. Okay. So I will remove the background, and then I'm gonna add a pinkish color for the fields. By the way, I'm using color picker extension to grab the color. Now I will add like a padding, like maybe 5% padding. And for the button, let's add, let's make it pink. And add a border. Make it pink. Okay, so now we are ready to connect our MailChimp. So go back to the content and then email, and then you choose your provider. So MailChimp, and then, by the way, I'm going to reset this one first so you can see like how you can connect your MailChimp. So MailChimp, and then add, and you will be asked your account name and API key. So where you can locate that. So go back to your MailChimp and go to the website. And website, and then domains, and you can see your account name or account name above the page. So this one is our account name, and then for the API, go to the extract and then API key. Then you need to generate an API or use the existing one. So I would really suggest once you generate an API, this will be automatically like the date it is created and then the label. So if you use that API, I really recommend that you put a label. So as you can see here, we have some labels, and I'm going to use this existing one and put it in here and then submit. So after that, you should able to see all the leads from your MailChimp account. Okay, so I'm going to select the leads that I created, and then we will also connect the custom fields that we created earlier. So yeah, so select the list that we created, and it's called Win Press, so that one. And then for the fields, I want to add the custom field that we created. So use the custom fields and then add a new field, and then what will be the name of the field you want to be added. I want the drop down thing in here, so you can see there, and these are the drop down thing. So if you want it to be hidden, you can also make that hidden. For some reason you cannot make it hidden, but yeah, I will not cover that one. Let me know if you want me to create a more detailed tutorial on this. But this is really how it works. If you configure first your email open and then create a list in MailChimp, you might get some problem in terms of fetching. Like you cannot see your custom fields, you cannot see your list. So that's why I'm giving you the exact process on how you do it. You first work on your MailChimp. You need to configure first your audiences in MailChimp, your list in MailChimp, configure the settings if it is a double open form or not, verify your domain and your email address in MailChimp. What else? You need to configure as well your custom fields if you want to add custom fields in your email open form in Divi. So that's the process. Always work on the email provider before diving to the module. So the process is still the same. It's not just for MailChimp, but also in other providers. So either it is an ActiveCampaign, Outreach, HubSpot, ConvertKit. So the process is the same. Work on your service provider first before you can figure that on your email.
So I hope you love the tutorial that I did. And by the way, I also have a tutorial for month redesign on Divi. So if you want to create a brick walls design on Divi, I have a tutorial for you in that. And again, you don't need to put any custom CSS for that. Everything is set up in the Divi Builder Designer tools. So that's it for today, guys. Down.